Hello, my dear students. Last class I explained about the pressure distribution diagram for the vertical stress on isobars and also the vertical stress on horizontal plane. Today we'll discuss about the vertical stress distribution on a vertical line. The vertical stress distribution on a vertical line due to a point load acting on the surface of soil mass can be determined using Buzyn's equation for vertical stress due to a point load. Keeping R constant, sigma z is calculated for different values of z. Sigma z decreases with increase in the depth z. On any vertical line distant r from the axis of the load, the variation of sigma z can be plotted from the relation sigma z is equal to kb into q divided by z square. Okay, here in this equation, the radial distance r that is associated with kb is constant. Okay, kb is equal to what? That is the ratio of r divided by z. Okay, by using the table you can you will be able to get this kb value. Here r is associated with the kb is constant, hence various values of z and r divided by z can be selected and kb can be found. Here you have to keep r value constant. Okay, so the z value you can change and get the value of kb. Based on the kb you can find what is sigma z. Then sigma z can be computed, which will be proportional to kb divided by z square. So here you can see in this table, in the previous case what happened, vertical stress distribution on a horizontal plane where z was kept constant. Okay, but here in this case, vertical stress distribution on a vertical line, r is constant with the different values of z. Okay, now you can see here this table. Okay, variation of sigma z with the z at constant r. R, let us take it as 1. Okay, so if z equal to 0, you have to assume z value. Okay, keep on changing the z value. R is constant. Okay, so what this ratio becomes? R divided by z, that is 1 divided by z. Okay, z is equal to 0 here. So 1 divided by z 0, that is infinity. So there is no value for kb. So this is indeterminate, intermediate. So we cannot find any stress value or vertical stress value for this case. Okay, next let us consider z is equal to 0.2. Okay, so what is r divided by z? R is equal to 1. 1 divided by 0.2, that is equal to 0.5. Now kb value corresponding to this ratio r divided by z, you have to find what is kb. So use the so this is 5. Use the table, that is for 5 value here. This is 4.91. okay, there is no value for 5, so you can consider this value, because after 4.91 to 6.15, the value is 0.0001. So you can consider 0.001. okay, so that's why here kb is equal to 0.0001. What is kb by z square? Find that kb is equal to 0.0001 divided by z square, that is 0.2 square. So we'll get 0.0025. So sigma z is equal to, we have this equation, sigma z is equal to kb into q divided by z square. So kb divided by q into q divided by z square. So kb by z square into q, that gives sigma z, correct? Based on this equation, sigma z is equal to kb divided by z square into q So kb divided by z square is 0.0025 into q. So this is sigma z. If you have the value of q, you can find what is the vertical stress for the depth point 2. Similarly, let us assume the different values for z. Let us consider 0.5. Any value can consider. These are the sum of the examples are shown. If z is equal to 0.5, what is this ratio? R divided by z. R is 1. 1 divided by 0.5, that is equal to 2. Find kb value using the table for 2. See here, there are some values for 0, 1 and 2 like that. So you can consider here 2. For 2 it is 0.0085. For 2.0085. So find kb divided by z square, that is 0.0085 divided by z is 0.5 square. So you get 0.0340. So what is sigma z? Sigma z is equal to kb divided by z square into q. So kb divided by z square is 0.0340 into q. Okay, let us consider the next value, 1, same thing, R by Z ratio. Now, 1 divided by 1, that is equal to 1. Use the table for 1. What is that? 0.0844. Okay, so 0.0844. Find KB by Z square, KB 0.0844 divided by 1, that is equal to 0.0844 only. Then into Q. That gives this value. Now, next value, you can consider two value. Okay, here what happens in this, I'll come to this point later. See, figure shows the vertical stress distribution on a vertical line at distance r from the axis of the loading. This figure you can see, this is a distribution of vertical line on vertical stress distribution on a vertical line. Okay, here this shows vertical stress distribution on a vertical line at distance r from the axis of the loading. This is the axis, so this is r. The vertical stress first increases, attains a maximum value, and then decreases. You can see here, it starts from here, increases, attains the maximum value, and then it is again decreases. It can be shown that maximum value of sigma z on a vertical line is obtained at the point of intersection of the vertical plane, okay, with the radial line at beta is equal to 39.15 through the point load as shown in the figure. Okay, so this is a standard value. Again, I will show how we get this value of beta. Okay, so the always this maximum value that we will obtain at the point of intersection of the vertical plane with the radial line. This is the radial line. So where this radial line intersects with the vertical plane, that point is called as, there will be a maximum sigma z value. Okay, intersection point of radial line and vertical plane. That angle is beta is equal to 39.15 degree. Okay, this I will show you how you get this value. Okay, so now the corresponding value of r divided by z, okay, that is equal to 0.817. Here z is considered as 1.225. Okay, so why this 1.225? We'll go back to this table here. See, suppose I considered this one value and I got 1 and we got these values. Now, suppose I consider 2. So, this is 0.5. So, the value of R by Z has decreased. So, for that, one intermediate value we can consider. You can consider 1.5 also. No problem. So, here in this example, it is considered 1.225. That is based on this distance. Okay. Z is equal to 1.225. Okay, any distance you can consider. Suppose if I consider 1.225, then R by Z becomes 0.817. Okay, now you can see here the value is decreased. Here there is a large difference between 1 to 0.5. So that's why intermediate one intermediate point is considered. Okay, that's point is 1.225. Can consider 1.5 also, not a problem. Then based on this you can find what is KB based on that table. Then you get what is KB divided by Z square, so that is equal to 0.0888 maximum value. This is the maximum value. Then you consider the next point. After 1 you consider this, then next consider 2, so we get 0.5. So KB value is 0.2733. So KB by Z square is 0.0683. So this becomes 0.0683. You can compare this value here. This is keep on increasing, 0.0025, 0.034, 0.08, here 0.0888. Then again it started decreasing, 0.0683. Okay, so that's why this value, intermediate value, is considered. Next, again for 4, you consider what is R, 1 divided by 4, that is equal to 0.25. Similarly, all the values you get. So, next again we'll come back to here. That's why this ratio is considered, because Z is equal to 1.225, or Z also equal to R divided by 0.817, that is nothing but 1.225. Now for which KB is equal to, for this ratio 0.817, KB is equal to 0.1332. So sigma maximum is equal to 0.088 Q, that is this value here, this maximum value. Like that you can find it for the other value also. Okay, so once if you have that values, you can draw vertical stress distribution diagram. Okay, let us take one this example. This Abusinus equation for vertical stress due to point load acting at surface is, this is the formula we are using to find the stress. For example, now Q is equal to 100 kN and R is equal to 2 meter. Then now R is constant. Okay, you have to find sigma z for the different values of z. So R is same. So if you write this equation, sigma z is equal to 150, that is 100 into 3, 150 into z cube, this equation. Okay, z cube divided by pi into R square. R is 2 square plus Z square. Z square we are changing, we are substituting the value, divided by 5 by 2. Now sigma Z is calculated for different values of Z using the above equation and plotted as shown in the figure. Take Z value as 0.5, substitute in this equation here and here, you get 0.16. Similarly, substitute 1, you get 0.85. Similarly, consider Z is equal to 2, you get 2.11. If Z is equal to 3, you get 2.12. If Z is equal to 4, 1.7. If Z is equal to 5, 1.32. If Z is equal to 6, 1.02. See here, this is a maximum value. After the you can see here, it is increasing, increasing, increasing. It reaches the maximum value and again it starts decreasing. Okay, so this is the maximum point. So now you draw, this is a line, horizontal line. The Q is acting here at a distance of R is equal to 2 meter. Now this is Z, Z for 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Write these values, 0.5, 0.16, for 1, 0.85, for 2, 2.11, for 3, 2.12, here, then for 4, it is 1.71, like that, note all the points and join the curve. You can see here it is maximum at this point and again it started decreasing. Okay, I hope all of you understood. So that maximum point location, that z is equal to 3 meter. Thank you.